Today, we will take up a topic on air gap magnetic field due to distributed windings. Now, before we do that, we must recap what we did in the last lecture. Last lecture, we primarily discussed a concentrated winding and identified that if you have concentrated winding with two coil sides, you will have a rectangular type of air gap MMF waveform with constant amplitude. That means, so that will be the starting point for today's lecture. So what we said was that if we have a concentrated winding, let us say a dash located in the stator, then we said that this will result in a rectangular waveform with an MMF positive in this zone and negative in this zone. Okay. And this A dash, of course, will be the same as here if you spread it out. So what you notice here is this portion has created a north pole here and this portion has created a south pole because your flux lines would be moving like this, leaving the stator surface, entering the rotor surface, and on that this side leaving the rotor surface and entering the stator surface. And we identified that the rotor surface MMF is 0. Therefore, this will attain a potential. In south pole, this will be at a lower potential than the stator, and north pole it will be higher potential. And we also identified that the amplitude of this will be Ni by 2, where N is the number of turns. How many turns are there in this coil? And the current passing through that is I, because current goes through A and comes out through A dash. And we have Ni by 2 here, that is plus Ni by 2, and here it will be minus Ni by 2. This is the MMF the stator surface would attain due to excitation of the coil. And we can also identify that at each point in the surface there is an MMF, and also it will also have an H, also a rectangular. Supposing I plot H versus theta, so H will also be, what will be the magnitude of H? Is Ni by 2 G, where G is the gap length. G is the gap length. So the H or the magnetic field intensity in the air gap at all these points will be plus Ni by 2 G, and at this point it will be minus Ni by 2 G. So H is positive here and H is negative here. Same is true with B. Are the magnetic field magnetic flux density, that will also be rectangular. So if you plot B versus theta, the amplitude of this will be mu naught into Ni by 2G. So we find in single coils, these are the effects that we see in the air gap. We see a rectangular MMF wave, we see a rectangular H wave, we see a rectangular B wave. Okay. And when we have that means we have created a half of the stator surface becomes north pole and other half of the stator surface becomes south pole. And we can also find out there is a flux per pole will be equal to whatever is the B into pole area. area of the pole. What will be the area of the pole? Will be B into pi d L by 2, because it is a 2 pole machine where d is the dia and L is the axial length, and this is the area of the pole, area per pole. We are not taking out the total area of the surface, because area per pole is area of the surface divided by number of poles. In this case, number of poles you have taken is 2. Okay. So, this will be the flux per pole that we see here, and we also identified that B wave will also have its fundamental component . So this will be the amplitude, is say let us say B1, that is the peak value of the fundamental of B, and the peak value of with that value the fundamental flux per pole will be that B1, that is the peak value, and its average will be 2 by pi, average due to fundamental will be 2 by pi into B1 into pi dl by pi 2. So, this will be the fundamental flux per pole, which is not necessarily total flux per pole. Okay. So, these are some of the related qualities of such a electromagnetic structure you must be aware of. Okay. Now, this is what we broadly discussed based on the last lecture, and we also know that machines are not necessarily built only for 2 poles. There are machines built for several poles, right? And let us see what will happen if you have a 4 pole machine instead of a 2 pole machine. Let us extend it to from 2 to 4 pole. Okay. Now, it will look like this. A 4 pole configuration, that means there will be the stator surface is now divided into 4 poles, and there will be this will be one coil A1 A1 dash, and A2 A2 dash. Okay. Now, when once you have a current goes inside I like this, the flux lines will be traversing like this. That means from this will become a 1 north pole, and this will become the returning south pole. Okay. And similarly, you have this current going out, so it will be other way around. So you will have a flux entering the air gap from the stator. So we create therefore 4 poles here. So compared to a 2 pole system, so we have created a south pole, north pole, another south pole, another north pole. 4 poles are created in this structure, and the south pole the fluxes are entering the stator surface, north pole the fluxes are leaving. So, here they leave, here they enter, and again in this case it is leaving, again this will enter here, and here it will leave here. We find here there are 2 coils minimum, I mean these are concentrated coils. So, A1 A1 dash and A2 A2 dash, right, and these 2 coils can be connected either in series like this, and are in parallel like this. We have two ways of connecting these two coils. In series means the current enter through A1, comes out through A1 dash, again enters through A2, comes out through A2 dash and comes out. So, this is the path where the same current will flow through the two windings. But if it is a parallel connection, it will A1, A2 being positive terminals of each coil, that is where the current goes in, and but whatever current goes in, half of it goes through one coil, half of it is the other coil. So, it will be I by 2 here, and this comes out. But polarities of these currents will be same, but magnitudes would change. That means for the same total current that is going into the winding, the MMFs may be different, because each coil will then carry different currents depending upon the type of connection. Now, if you spread it out, you have A1, A1 dash and then A2, A2 dash in a spread of 0 to 2 pi. For a mechanical spread of 0 to 2 pi, you have 4 poles, but you know between the poles it is always pi electrical degrees, north pole to south pole. So, what we see here if you go back to the earlier picture, you have this portion, though it is 90 degrees mechanical, is 180 degrees electrical. Supposing north pole, so axis of north pole, axis south pole is 90 degrees mechanical, but it is 180 degrees electrical. Okay. So, you notice that this concept that there is a mechanical angle and an electrical angle, right? And MMF therefore will be twice the theta. So, here theta is the mechanical degree, say theta mechanical. So, we have theta mechanical, but if theta E is the theta electrical, we have the general expression that the theta electrical is always equal to P by 2 theta mechanical, that is where P is the number of poles. So, when we have more number of poles, we must be careful not to use the mechanical degrees. Whenever you are dealing with electrical quantities, you must use electrical degrees, right? And electrical degrees have to be calculated from mechanical degrees by multiplying by the pair of poles P by 2. Okay. Now, with this, let us go back to this MMF waveform. Now, obviously, just like a 2 pole system, the 4 pole system will also create a rectangular MMF waveform. So, the A1 current goes in and A1 dash current comes out. So, what will be the flux lines? So, flux lines will be like this. And similarly, it may be the other way around here. So, we have created this portion as a north pole, and since it enters here, the other portion, this portion will be a south pole. This is the north pole because the flux leaves the surface, this is the south pole, flux entering the surface. And we can similarly say A2 dash current coming out. I hope all of you are aware what is done by these conventions. If it is a cross, means the current is going into the paper just like an arrow. If an arrow is entering, at the back of the arrow you will see a cross. If it is coming out, means you will see the tip of the arrow. So, the tip of the arrow, that means here, if a dot means it is current is coming out. When the current is coming out, you find the flux lines will be like this. So, in this portion again, you will notice that the flux in this portion, it creates a north pole. And we do go to the other again A2, A2 again being a cross current, it will create, so this will become a south pole. So we have created one north pole, one south pole, one north pole, one south pole. So there are, it creates four poles. And you will notice that each coil side, this is a coil side, this is another coil side. So what will be the span of a coil? This is the coil span, okay, or coil pitch or whatever you may say. What is the angle degrees of this? Will be 90 degrees mechanical, but it is 180 degrees electrical. So we always say that a coil if you say this is the span of a coil or PC or whatever it is always equal to pi degrees electrical, but in this case it is pi by 2 mechanical. It is 90 degrees mechanical, a coil span is 90 degrees mechanical and 180 degrees electrical. So you must differentiate that the coil span mechanically is not the same for different number of poles, that will change. For 2 pole it is 180 degrees and for 4 pole it is 90 degrees, and again as the number of poles increase the coil span will become smaller and smaller mechanically, but it will all be electrically 180 degrees. Okay. So we have seen this. Therefore, if you plot the MMF wave F at the air gap with reference to theta, with reference to theta electrical, you will again see that this will have a constant potential here between in the north pole, that will be F will be a positive, and then this portion will be negative because it is creating a south pole, and this portion again is positive creating a north pole, and this side is negative. And what you see a dotted line here is the fundamental of this, whose peak would be equal to 4 by pi times this amplitude. Okay. Now from the same logic which we saw, that if the number of turns are n here, then again this portion will be ni by 2. If the number of turns in each of the coil is n, this will be ni by 2, and this will be minus ni by 2 plus ni by 2 and so on, and its fundamental will be again 4 by pi times ni by 2. But now your flux per pole will not be same as 2 pole because your pole area is half of the earlier one, right. Now what will be the pole area is pi d by, what is pole area? Area in this case pi d l by 4. For a p pole we can say pi d l by p. For a p pole machine area of the pole is pi d l by p. Okay. Therefore, you will notice for the same stator structure, for different number of poles, the flux per pole may change depending upon the type of excitation that you are giving. So you find on the same 2 pi mechanical degrees here, you now have a 2 cycles, right, or for 4 pi it is 2 cycles here, or electrically it is always pi is the 1 cycle. Okay. Electrically this is pi, this is pi electrically, sorry, this is 2 pi electrically, and this is 4 pi. Okay. So 2 pi mechanical will then become 4 pi electrical. You got 2 cycles when you traverse through 1 rotation. If you traverse through 1 rotation of the surface of the stator, you have seen 4 poles. You experience 2 south pole, 2 north poles if you traverse through the surface 1 times. Okay. Supposing n is the total turns per phase. Per phase you have n turns, then each coil will have turns per coil will be n by 2, right? Your total turns n is because you have now 2 coils. They may be connected differently, but it will have n by 2. And if the current is total input current is I, then the if it is series, the coil current is also I, okay. But if it is parallel, the coil current is I by 2. These are differences you must notice. So, you must know NC turns will be total turns by 2, and but the currents will be different. Next, for a peephole machine, any number of general peephole machine, the MMF is therefore can be written as the fundamental peak F1. F1 is the fundamental peak sine of P by 2 times theta m. This is a general expression. Okay. What is F1? F1 is the peak of the fundamental which you see in the earlier pictures. Let us say this is the F1. That is the peak, and the you can write it as F1 sin theta electrical. Therefore, we have seen the two coils A1, A1 dash, A2, A2 dash can be connected in series or parallel. Two ways we are connecting these two as we have seen in this picture. We are connected A1, A1 dash, A2, A2 dash series here, and these two are connected in parallel here. So, we now see the two types of connections. So, for each one your calculations are likely to be different. So, you must be careful while doing the calculation of MMF for different type of configurations. Next is, what is the magnitude of the rectangular MMF wave? Magnetic MMF wave will be the whatever is the coil turns into coil current divided by 2, NC IC by 2, which will be NI by 4 for series and will be NI by 8 for parallel, right, where I is the input current and N is the total turns. Okay, NC will be N by 2, but I will change. Okay. So, if NS is the number of series turns, number of that means number of turns connected in series, right. So, if they are connected, total turns connected in series will be the two coils. Okay. If it is parallel, it will be one coil. That means, if I go back to this, so let us say if N is the total turns, N series in this case will be what? N only. And here what will be N series? Half of it are connected in series. So, it will be N by 2. So, we must be clear what is meant by number of series turns. That is the turns which are connected in series. So, more parallel paths means less turns in series. Okay. Now, NSC is equal to N in a series connection and NSC is equal to N by 2 in parallel connection. Right. So, these are the factors you must be aware of. So, for a peephole machine, the air gap MMF will be NAC I by P. P is number of poles, is a general expression now. What will be the amplitude of a rectangular wave? Will be NAC is the number of turns series connected into I is the total current that is going in divided by P, or its fundamental will be 4 by pi NSE I by P. This is the amplitude of the rectangular wave and this will be the fundamental. We multiply by 4 by P. Therefore, we have a general expression for fundamental MMF wave for a peephole machine with concentrated windings. We are all now only concentrated. That means, we have kept a coil in only one coil and two coil sides in two slots at 180 degrees electrical. Okay. Therefore, we have a f as a function of theta, that is if you traverse through theta, that means f for MMF wave will be 4 by pi times NAC I by P, that is the peak, into sine of theta E, where theta E is the electrical angle. So, it is a sine wave. We are only trying to consider this fundamental of that rectangular wave. So, and we also, this is an important which we are repeating that coil span always is 180 degrees electrical. Okay. So, we have so far seen that if the coils are all concentrated, then you get rectangular waveforms. You have as many rectangular waves as there are poles over the periphery, and you can find out its fundamental component, and when else you have the fundamental component, you can calculate the flux per pole, etc. Ideally, you would like to have sinusoidal MMF distribution in the periphery of the stator, and rectangular waveform is just the reality with a concentrated coil. Okay. So, next, now we will say if you do not have concentrated coil, if you distribute the coils, whether we get anything better, right? Because your ideal situation is a sinusoidal waveform of MMF in the periphery of the surface, and that is an ideal situation. Okay. So, we will now like to see the distributed one. Before that, where are we see distributed windings? Distributed winding we typically see in three-phase machines. Three-phase machines have three-phase distributed windings, that is quite universal. Okay. Therefore, we will look at the windings of a three-phase machine. Next, a three-phase, we want to go to distributed, but first because since we have understood already what is concentrated winding, let us go that step. So, we have seen a single phase concentrated winding 2 pole, single phase concentrated winding 4 pole. Now, in 3 phase means there will be 3 times that. What we saw earlier was for 1 phase, say A phase. Now, we will see what will happen to B phase and C phase. So, we would like to see, I will show you the figure. So, we will have a 3 phase concentrated winding. So, that is one thing. Now, that means these phases are, we call it as ABC phases. Earlier, we had only one phase. We have 3 phases ABC, but they are displaced by 120 degrees. 120 degrees electrical, not mechanical. These ABC phases are displaced in space by 120 degrees. Now, we want to know the MMF waveforms of each are rectangular. Each of the MMF wave of each phase will then be rectangular, but they would be displaced in space by 120 degrees. That is next thing we will say. Because since the winding this themselves were displaced by 120 degrees, their waveforms also would be displaced by 120 degrees, but those displaced waveforms are all rectangular. So, only rectangles get displaced by 120 degrees. Okay. And their fundamentals also will be displaced by 120 degrees. Is it clear? Okay. So, we have three phase windings, 120 degrees displaced in space, and when they carry currents, it will create MMF waveforms which are rectangular. But you now you do not see one waveform, now you will see three waveforms, and they are displaced by 120 degrees in space. So, this is how it looks like, a three phase concentrated winding. So, earlier we had only one coil, AA dash, that was what we started, 2 pole, again this is a 2 pole system. Now, I will have two more coils chain, that means this is A axis, B axis and C axis. So, A coil, that means it will produce a flux like this, this is the axis of the coil. So, you must be clear, the this is not the axis of the coil. Axis of the coil is the axis of the flux produced by the coil. So that will look like this. So you say you have created a north, if you excite this, you have created a north pole, south pole like this. So this will form a north pole, this will form the south pole. Okay. Now B will be like this. So my B coil will be like this, perpendicular to the axis of the coil. So there will be B, current goes in B here, current comes out in B here. Okay. So we have a coil, let us say A dash, and let us say there is a B coil. BB dash. Let's say there is a C coil, CC dash. Okay, and the current enters always through ABC and come out through A dash, B dash, C dash. Okay, now similarly C coil we have a cross here going in like this, and so this will create a MMF in this centered around here. So A coil will produce an MMF like this. B coil will produce an MMF like this, C coil will produce an MMF like this. This will be the axis of the coils. Okay. So when only one of them are excited, it will create one south pole, one north pole. So you will notice the south pole, north pole created by each of the coils are not identical. They are not at the same position. So if A coil is excited, this portion becomes north, this portion becomes south. If B coil is excited, then you will have one portion becoming north, another portion becoming south, like this. Okay, and we can show you the three waveforms. So what we hear is, supposing you know I spread it out, you have A dash. You have A coil A dash, B coil BB dash, C coil CC dash. And interestingly, if you go back to that picture, you will see if you traverse in this direction, a clockwise direction, you first see A, then you see C dash, then you see B, then you see A dash, then you see C, then you see B dash. So this is what you will see if you traverse through. So it means you can call it as a belt. A belt, so you have A, C dash, B, A dash, C. Okay, this is the sequence of coil sides you will see. Okay, so you if I spread it out, if I cut it at some point and spread it out, it will be like that: A, C dash, B, A dash, and I come back A dash, C, B dash. If I traverse like this. Now, if I excite only A dash and keeping other two windings unexcited, are they are dead. So you will create a rectangular waveform like this, isn't it? So only A dash will be like this, exciting A. I am not exciting B or C, and it will have its fundamental, and its peak amplitude of the rectangular will be Ni by 2, where N is the number of turns in A coil, I is the current in the A coil, IA, let us say this we call it as IA. So N into IA by 2 is a rectangular MMF wave. Okay. Then its fundamental will be 4 by pi of that, 4 by pi into N IA by 2. Suppose I excite the B coil. B coil is centered like this. So B will have a rectangular wave like this. So this will be north pole, this will be south pole. And you will notice that this axis and the other axis will be 120 degrees. Each of this is 60 degrees, okay, shifted. BB dash like this. And if you excite the C winding, next one, that will be along the C axis. So you will find the C axis is C winding produce an MMF like this. So the MMFs FA, FB, FC, the three MMFs are displaced by 120 degrees in space. So their axes are displaced. So you have seen this is here, this is somewhere here, and this comes somewhere here. Okay. And their fundamentals also will be displaced. Their fundamental components are also displaced. So what you find here, if you have three phase windings carrying currents, they will create three phase MMF waveforms displaced in space. So each will create their own north pole, south poles. So north pole, south pole of A will be displaced by north pole, south pole of B by 120 degrees. North pole, south pole of C would be displaced by north pole, south pole of B by 120 degrees. So we can say, supposing you know you have A north pole, south pole like this, maybe B north pole, south pole like this, maybe C north pole, south pole like this. Okay. So you will have three sets of north pole, south poles. Okay. Now we have seen three phase concentrated winding, two pole. What will happen to four pole? If it is four pole, again there will be the same thing get replicated once more, right? If it is four pole, if it is six pole, it gets replicated three times like that. So same set of coils will repeat. So now we have three coils. If it is four pole, you will have six coils minimum, okay, and that will go. Now we will take up the so called distributed winding. Now in the distributed winding, you have three phase distributed windings which are used generally in DC machines, and we will show you the figure now. A single layer 3 phase 2 pole machine, and we have taken a case of 3 slots per pole per phase. For each phase you have 3 slots per pole, means it will be 6 slots per phase. Okay. And these are say we say ABC are the 3 phases at 120 degrees. Okay. Okay. So this is how it looks like. So we have A, earlier we had only one coil side at A, now I have three coil side at A. Again A dash will have three coil sides, not one. So this is a distributed winding. Supposing earlier I had 300 conductors per slot, now I will have 100 conductors per slot spread out in three slots. Okay. There are three slots here, three slots for A phase. Similarly it will happen to B phase, that is B and B dash. Again, so this will be the B phase and this will be the C phase, and this portion we call it as a phase belt. So this is one phase belt or A phase belt, this is a belt, it is not a one conductor, it is a belt of conductors, A phase belt. If you traverse through that, you get a A phase belt, then C dash phase belt, then B phase belt, then A dash phase belt, then C phase belt, and B dash phase belt. So you now find not 6 coil side but 6 phase belts, okay, because they are distributed. Okay. That means we have got in this case there are 24 slots. If you can number it to 1 to 24, there are 6 slots per phase. So I can go on numbering, let us say I call it as 1, 2, 3 and I come down to 24 here, right? And there are 6 slots dedicated for one phase. Each phase occupies 6 slots. There are 3 phases, so there are total of 6 into 3, 18 slots, no? Sorry, it's not 24, it is 18 slots. We can make this correction. It there are 18 slots. This is 18th. Okay. 18 slots. Each phase belt occupies 3 slots. these are the information you should know. There are 6 phase belts in sequence. So, you have C dash, B, A dash, then C, B dash, as we have seen. Okay. Now, our concern is how to get the MMF waveform of a distributed winding. How to get a net MMF for phase A? Let us say only A phase is excited. Okay. We are not, B and C phases will be repeating. Okay. Now, the procedure is you use a simple superposition. We have seen how you do for one coil. You just write it for each of the coils and then sum it up. So, what you do is draw MMF waveform for each coil. First you draw for A1, A1 dash, then you draw for A2, A2 dash, then you draw for A3, A3 dash. So, you have, so let us say you have A1, you these two you draw one, then these two you draw another rectangular, and these two you draw another rectangles. So, what you do, will these 3 rectangles will be identical? They will be identical in shape, but they will be phase shifted by an angle. What is that angle will be? Let us say this angle. Let us say alpha. So, alpha in this case is slot angle. That means angle between the 2 slots, isn't it? This angle between these 2 slots, let us say alpha here. What is the angle here? Slot angle here will be? It is 360 divided by how many slots? 18 slots. So, that will be 20 degrees mechanical, which is also equal to 20 degrees electrical here, because we have taken a 2-pole machine. If it is 4-pole, it could be different. Okay. So, we have a slot angle. So, these two will be shifted by 20 degrees. Okay. Now, add them at each position to get resultant wave. So, what you do is, we get 3 rectangular waves displaced by a slot pitch or a slot angle. Okay. Add them at each position in the air gap radially and get resultant waveform. This is what procedure we will follow. Okay. And resultant will be a stepped wave which will be nearing sinusoidal. We will notice it will be a stepped wave, but it will be nearing a sinusoidal. Okay. So, let us see this. Like this. So, we have A1, A2, A3, but other one is A1 dash, A2 dash, A3 dash. Just okay. Now, if you take only A1, the first one, A1, A1 dash, let us say these two. Now, A1, A1 dash, here it will create a rectangle like this. It will be along A1, A1 dash with a peak value of Ni by 2, where n is the number of conductors per slot and I is the current in that conductor. So, Ni by 2, when current is, this is what you will have. If you have the second one, let us say A2, A2 dash, this is here, A2, A2 dash again will create another rectangle, but between shifted by this, between the two is 20 degrees, okay, these two. And similarly, you have the third one, A3, let us say A3, A3 dash, this one will be another one. Okay. Now, if you sum it up, you will find it is a little jumbled up here. So, typically, you will notice okay, I will take it in a fresh sheet. So, you will typically notice a stepped waveform something like this. For that you can try. So, this will be 3 times Ni by 2, each one is Ni by 2. This will be the typical waveform that you will get. Okay. And you will notice, so there is a this portion is occupied by other 2 phases. Okay. That means if you traverse through this, it will see a step. When once you traverse from this point to this point, you find an MMF jump of Ni, because now N is the number of conductors and I is the number of current carried. If you go from here to here, you are again jump, right? So again here to here you jump, but from here to here you don't jump because there is nothing, it is all dead, okay? And again you jump down. So this, while there is a positive thing here, then it comes down here, and then so you have a Ni, 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 and then go here minus Ni, minus Ni, minus Ni. So you will find there is a jump if you saw Ni, I know each one. So from here there is Ni jump, Ni, and then minus Ni, like this. And you will notice that there will be, you can draw a fundamental of this. So this will be the fundamental. Okay, so this you can try out just by drawing the three rectangles. Okay, so we will finally have to get what is the amplitude of that fundamental. I mean, your interest is, given the design dimensions of the design details of the machine, like number of turns, current carried, slots, etc. So we must find out what is the peak of the MMF. So we do these calculations like this. Let NSE be the number of series turns per phase. In fact, these definitions you must be clear. That means number of turns connected in series in each phase. Okay. Now NC is the number of turns per coil. If NC is the number of turns per coil, will be in this case NSE by 3, because there are 3 coils connected in series, A1, A2, A3. 3 coils are there, so that will be 1/3 of that, and that will also be the same as number of conductors per slot. Number of turns per coil is also equal to number of conductors per slot, because you know you make a coil, let us say it has NC. NC turns is also equal to NC conductors per slot. Each slot will have NC conductors. If there are 100 turns coil, each slot will have 100 conductors, because other side will have other 100 conductors. Okay. Now, we are into amplitude of rectangular wave for each coil. Each coil amplitude is NC into I by 2, where I is the current carried by that coil, isn't it? NC into I by 2 is the amplitude of the rectangular wave for each coil. That is also equal to NSE into I by 6, where my NSE is 3 times NC. Okay. So that is one formula you must be aware of. Therefore, we want to know what is the, we are interested in this one, what is the amplitude of the fundamental. We are interested in this, and amplitude of the fundamental is given by 4 by pi kw NSE by p into Ia, where kw is known as a winding factor, because we will do it separately. It is a factor which is decided by the method way it is distributed, and often it will also include the short pitch. When the coil span is not 180, it could be less than 180 degrees. So finally, we again rewrite this general expression. General expression for fundamental MMF per phase. Per phase means you are exciting only one coil, A phase, it is a distributed winding, and it may even have P number of poles. The fundamental, or amplitude of the fundamental, is 4 by pi kw NSE by p. Okay. And sorry, okay, yeah, this is what yeah, I think it is okay. Amplitude is 4 by pi kw NSE by p into Ia, which is amplitude. When that is the amplitude, And if you say this is the theta equal to 0, if you take the peak value from there, if you measure, the FA will be that amplitude FA 1 into cos theta. That means you have a fundamental wave due to a distributed winding, which we have seen something like this. So, this may have a fundamental wave, and with amplitude we have determined, and all you need to know the amplitude is therefore winding factors, number of series turns per phase, number of poles, and the current, and the current carried by in each phase. So, today we have studied the MMA waveform of a three-phase distributed winding.